Hi to all. Today we will discuss about magnetic flow meter. Okay, here before explaining this magnetic flow meter, I will tell what is flow meter. Flow meter means it will indicate the reading of the discharge or flow. Okay, so for flow or discharge, we both are same. Okay, we are giving two symbol. So units are for this formula is how much volume of water is coming from a given pipe or turbine or pump like that per time. Okay. Or we can call it as volume units are meter cube. Time units are either second, minutes, hour like that. Okay, how much meter cube per second water is flowing in a pump or in a tank? We can find by using the meter. It is called flow meter. We can find like in a pipe if you are taking. Okay, so how much discharge? How much 3 liters of water is coming per second like that? Okay. This 3 liters of per second water is called discharge or flow. Okay, so here we can find by using the flow meter. We have to connect the flow meter to the pipe for finding the Q value. Here, in which places we are using this flow meter? Okay, so here in we are seeing in petrol bunks. We are paying money for the petrol or fuel. So they are seeing the Q value, how much petrol they are giving. So they are calculating the money accordingly. So there we are using the flow meters, and here in pumps, turbines and engines also we are calculating how much water is taking in at inlet of the turbine. Okay, discharge, how much volume is flowing at inlet, how much volume is coming at outlet, like that. Here we are connecting one flow meter, here also we are connecting one flow meter for finding the discharge at inlet and outlet of the turbine or pump or engine. And sometimes we are using in medical field also for finding the blood flow in the vein. Special type of flow meters they are using. So for different purposes, different flow meters we are using in different fields. In this class we will take magnetic flow meters. It will measure the flow rate of conducting fluid. So here the flowing fluid, whatever fluid is going in the pipe, it is the conducting fluid. Conducting fluid means which will pass the electricity through it. It is called conducting. Okay. Whatever material we are taking, if it is passing the electricity through it, it is called conducting material. Here we are taking fluid. Okay, fluid. This fluid has conducting property, means it will pass the electricity through it. So that fluid we are taking for measuring the flow of the, for finding the flow rate of conducting fluid, we are using this magnetic flow meter. Okay. So here we are using two different names. Magnetic, here we are using conducting. Just now I told conducting means which will pass the electricity through it. It is called conducting fluid. Okay. But here we are using the magnetic also. So here we are taking the two fields. One is magnetic field. In it, this conducting fluid is flowing. Okay. So let us take the working principle of it. For explaining this working principle, I am taking two magnets like this. If I am keeping two magnets like this, means in this gap magnetic field will generate. Okay, now I am sending the fluid which has conductivity. Okay, so this fluid is called conducting fluid. I am sending the fluid in this way. The fluid name is conducting fluid. How can we send the fluids? By using the pipes. Okay, here pipe material is non-conducting. Let us assume I am taking one pipe here. This pipe material is non-conducting. Only the fluid, flowing fluid, is conducting material. Okay, so I am sending this conducting fluid through this non-conducting material in the magnetic field. Whenever this fluid, conducting fluid, will cut the magnetic field, okay, voltage will generate in this area. Okay, that voltage, how to find the voltage? We have to connect two wires or two terminals to the pipe here for the non-conducting pipe. So we have to connect voltmeter here. Okay. Here we have to observe one thing. This is a magnetic field. Okay. And this flow is perpendicular to this. Okay. So it is called transverse. Okay. Magnetic field. The flow is transverse to the magnetic field. Not in the same direction. Flow is. It is perpendicular to the magnetic field, flow is. So it is important. So whenever this conducting fluid is passing through the magnetic field, it will cut the magnetic field and induce the voltage. Okay, this voltage is proportional to the velocity of the flowing fluid. The generated voltage or produced voltage is proportional to the velocity of the this conducting fluid. Okay, this is the working principle of this flow meter. Okay, what we are doing is we are taking the magnets, we are generating the magnetic field, we are sending the conducting fluid through this by using one non-conducting pipe. Whenever this conducting fluid cuts the magnetic field, voltage will generate. This voltage will give the velocity of the conducting fluid. Okay, if velocity is more, this voltage is also more. If it is flowing slowly, less velocity, the voltage produced voltage is also less. The voltage is proportional to the velocity of the conducting fluid. This is the main working principle. Let us take, this is the conducting fluid in this direction. Okay, magnetic field is in this direction, like this magnetic field. It is perpendicular to this. It is called transverse. Okay, so according to this working principle, when a flowing conducting fluid is subjected to transverse magnetic field, the flowing conducting fluid cuts the magnetic field and causes a voltage to be induced. This induced voltage is proportional to the velocity of the conducting fluid. Okay, that is the flow rate. If you know the velocity, so by using this, how can we find Q value? Okay, velocity it will give, voltage, how to find Q value? Area of the pipe into velocity. So this velocity we can take here. So indirectly this voltage will give the Q value. Area, how to calculate this circular pipe area? Pi by 4. If you are taking D diameter, pi by 4 D square into whatever velocity is there, that velocity means in terms of voltage, calibrated scale we are taking, it will give the discharge. Okay, this is the main working principle. Let us take the description of this magnetic flow meter. Here I am taking two magnets, okay, two poles, magnetic poles. So here I am supplying conducting fluid, okay, through this pipe, but this pipe is non-conducting pipe. So flow is conductive fluid. Okay, and here if we are keeping this magnetic field like this, okay, horizontal, the flow is perpendicular to it. Okay, and here whatever voltage is coming from this, here these two are the terminals, like we are connecting to the voltmeter. Okay, whatever voltage is coming, electrodes we can call. Okay, so here these arrows are the magnetic field. The entire space between the two magnet is magnetic field. These are the main parts of the magnetic flow meter. Let us take the operation of this magnetic flow meter. In it, initially I am taking two magnets. Okay, because of it, magnetic field will generate. These arrows will show the direction of the magnetic field. In the transverse direction means perpendicular. Okay, perpendicular to each other. The magnetic field is like this. The flow is perpendicular to that direction. So I am sending the conducting fluid through the pipe in between the poles. Here I am taking this pipe is non-conducting pipe. Okay, but the fluid is conducting. Here I am connecting two terminals or electrodes to this pipe here. Now here, because of this flowing fluid, this is a conducting fluid, it will cut the magnetic field here. So here also the entire inside of this fluid also magnetic field will generate. Okay, magnetic field will generate. Whenever flow is coming like this, this flow is cutting the magnetic field. Okay, because of it, voltage will generate. Okay, so that voltage we can find by using this connecting electrodes to the pipe. We are connecting two electrodes or wires to the pipe. Okay, whatever voltage is generated in the fluid, we can measure by connecting these two terminals to the voltmeter like this. Okay, this voltage, whatever voltage is generated in the voltmeter, that voltage will find the Q value in the flow. Okay, so this is the main working operation of this magnetic flow meter. Here it is following this magnetic flow meter is following the Faraday's law. According to this law, the induced voltage E is equal to B into L into V. In it, E is induced voltage, just now I told, and B is magnetic flux density. Here the density of the magnetic field will form, that is B is flux density, we are taking units gauss. L means conducting of the pipe. So from this place to this place means diameter of the pipe. We can take it is the diameter of the pipe. And then V, what is V here? Velocity, average velocity of the flowing fluid. Okay. Nowadays, instead of these separate parts, the term this flow meter is coming like this. This is small pipe, magnets are fixing here, and these terminals are so perpendicular means here, here one terminal, here one, and here one, like this. It is connected to voltmeter. This is the small part, it is called flow meter, magnetic flow meter. Wherever we want to connect to the pipes, we can easily connect to the pipe. Okay, for finding the Q value, how much it is. Have you observed why the voltage will generate? Okay, we are telling whenever this is passing through it in this field, because of striking of the conducting material in the magnetic field, voltage is generating. How voltage is generating? Let us do rough diagram here. This is the magnetic field we are taking. Okay, this is the pipe. Okay, so I am sending conducting material means positive ions, it has negative ions, conducting fluid means. Okay, so positive and negative ions are flowing in it. So let us take whatever positive will be there in this area. One side positive ions will coming, let us assume this side all positive ions are coming. Okay, separated here, this side positive ions, this side negative ions will come. Okay, after some time both will mix here, positive ions and negative ions are flowing. Okay, like this. In this gap, positive ions will separate and negative ions will getting separate. Because of this change, voltage is developed. Okay, like it is like battery. For battery also, there are two ends. One is positive end, one is negative end. If you are connecting to this circuit, it will generate the current. It will generate the voltage. So similarly, because of this separation of the ions, here voltage will generate. This is the main basic reason for generating the voltage in this gap. Here separated, after that again this will be like initial state. Okay, both will combine and flowing in this direction. What are the applications of this flow meter? First application is we are using these flow meters for finding the flow rate of conducting fluid. Okay, so this next application is we are supplying the fluids for the bigger machines. Supplying like a coolant like that. Okay, some coolant we are supplying to the lathe machines and cutting machines like that. We are adding some abrasives also. Okay, for effective machining. Okay, so for finding that flow rate also, abrasive material coolant. Okay, so that there also we can use the flow meters. So for effective machining, how much coolant we are supplying to the machine. And in some chemical industries also, for supplying the chemical direct continuously, we are checking the flow rate by connecting to the pipe. Here we are connecting the pipe to the flow meter. Okay, so here it can be used to measure. Let us take in bidirection also. Means bidirection means if you are taking the fluid, we can take the fluid in opposite direction also, not always in one direction. Okay, bidirectional flow also, it will give the correct value. Means reversing direction of the fluid also, it will give the correct value. And what are the advantages of this flow meters means, here there are no moving parts. Okay, it is the main advantage, it will give the correct reading. And then no pressure drop is there. Okay, here also I told just now, here ions are getting separate, but pressure is constant throughout the pipe, there is no pressure difference. So whatever flow is coming, it is accurate. Okay, and then it is not taking, it is not affect with the laminar flow or turbulent flow. Laminar means the flow is in systematic way. It is called laminar. Turbulent flow means in the zigzag manner, okay, like this, okay, not in order. So for both types of flow, for laminar flow and turbulent flow, this will give the correct reading, okay. And then and it can give the flow rate of grease material, greasing material. Greasing material means we are using for reducing the friction in the machine parts. Those material also it can handle. Limitations are same thing. It is not giving the correct value of non-conducting fluid. And then the other limitation is the fluid should be full in the pipe. Okay. If it is level of the fluid is less, it will give the wrong Q value, discharge value. The other limitation is sometimes air and gas bubbles will form in the flow. Because of it, the voltage generated will give the wrong value. The next limitation is here we are connecting the terminals or electrodes. We are supplying different fluids for finding the Q value. Okay, so here whatever parts are there, end parts, yeah, this will coating to the this flow coated with the flow material. Whatever flow is there, let us assume if you are taking grease. Okay, that oil will be cling to these surfaces of the electrodes. We have to remove these surfaces. We have to clean these parts and we have to keep at the same place. So cleaning should be there for the electrodes. This is the main limitation of this.